Welcome back to a pretty raucous Keys Centre, ready for the Australian Open 2022. We've had three finals already. We've whizzed right through it, haven't we, today? With the mixed doubles, women's doubles, and then women's singles. Now on to the men's singles, the fourth of the five finals here. It's an all-China affair as Lu Guangzu takes on compatriot Shi Yu Qi. This is how they got there. I was speculating yesterday as to whether it could be an all-Chinese affair. And it certainly is the case. Lu Guangzu won this title back in 2018. Shi Yu Qi continues his comeback as well. Here is how it looks in the men's singles race to Bangkok. The road to Bangkok, I should say. Lu Guangzu, because of his performance here and the fact that he played Li Zijia, certainly helped. Let's meet the players now.
All right, Chinese fans, it's time to welcome your players on the court. Lu Guangzu from China. He'll be taking on Shi Yu Qi from China.
Well, as you heard there from the MC, a treat for Chinese fans to have two of their own facing off in the men's singles final. Two men, of course, also will be pretty familiar with each other. But three times before, Shi Yu Qi won that last meeting. It was more than 2 years ago. He won it relatively comfortably, 21-16, 21-12. Won 2018. He's 26 years of age, 19th in the world currently. His highest ranking was 17th back in May of 2019. From Jiangsu. He's also won the Canada Open back in 2018, so looking for his third title. Li Zijia is the one that really stands out here, the top seed, who needed to get a good performance in at the Australian Open to force his way into the World Tour Finals. Instead, it's at the expense of him. Lu Guangzu has done it instead. He's squeezed in. And fine performance yesterday against Guang Zu. Shi Yu Qi, a former world number two. That was more than 5 years ago. Now 26 years of age, 184 centimeters tall. He's got a little bit of a height advantage there. Currently 29th as he returns to the sport. He's won plenty in his time. The World Tour five titles, most recently the Denmark Open, where he beat, again, Li Zijia. Couple of seeds along the way. He's dropped games, but one of them is the former world champion Lo Kian Yu of Singapore. The second seed in a tough old match against Kode Naraoka yesterday. What a marathon that was. And a tight finish as well. 21-19. Officials for this one, Joshua Ho. Service judge Susan Taylor. Yeah. Shi Yu Qi's former runners up in the World Championships back in 2018. He's won Sudirman Cups with China 2019-2021. Thomas Cup team in 2018. gold medalist in the men's team event at the Asian Games. You were working on that game yesterday, weren't you, Shi Yu Qi and Koda Naraoka, and he was making a fair few unforced errors as well.
Yeah, he definitely had some lapses in concentration in that second set that he dropped, but he held it together, obviously, by the end of the third set to get the win there. It was, yeah, quite big swings in momentum every now and then.
How do you see this one panning out then?
Oh, hard to say. I mean, I think with Shi Yu Qi's experience and, you know, having been top five before, that he is probably the favorite going into this. But yeah, we'll have to see how it starts out.
Lu Guang Zu has been playing well.
Being compatriots, they're probably pretty familiar with each other's game as well. Play.
That's a fine way to start things off for Shi Yu Qi.
One love.
Character that he is. And a couple of quick points for him as well.
Service
over. 3-1. For those of you who love the numbers, Lu Guang Zu comes into this, 143 matches in his career, 87 wins, 56 defeats. This year he's played 32 matches, 18 wins, 14 losses. Shi Yu Qi, 306 matches, 224 wins, 82 defeats. That's a fine shot from Lu. And this year alone for Shi Yu Qi. After his return to badminton, he's won 9 out of 13.
3-4.
What an achievement to win the Denmark Open when you return.
Yeah, super impressive. I think a lot of these players that came from the German Open straight to here is, and they're making finals, is very impressive.
Yeah.
I know when I travel back to Europe, it takes nearly a week just to get used to the jet lag, let alone play some very high-level badminton. Yeah, so I wonder what times they're waking up during the nights or days here.
Can't be easy at all. Playing well. She at the moment, 5-3. Five, three. clearly in.
Service over. 4-5.
Last time they ever met was in 2019 at the Indonesia Masters, round of 32. Shi Yu Qi won that one. 21-13, 21-15. Later that year, round of 32, the China Open, where Liu thrashed Shi Yu Qi in just 15 minutes, 21-5, 21-9. And then, of course, that result at the Malaysia Masters, Shi Yu Qi won. Get it over.
Really good net play in this game so far.
6-7.
Wonderfully done down the line from Shi Yu Qi. Nonchalant in his execution. Do it too. Yu Guang Zu. Watching each other quite well at the moment. 7-8. Great rally, good winner from Liu Guang Zu.
Again, this net shot there, setting it up for that short lift. Big smash.
For Liu Guang Zu, just in front now. Eight. He's really found his mark, hasn't he?
Yeah, super. Precise smashes right now from both players. Very impressive how consistently they seem to find the line. in their smashes.
It's just in.
Service over. 9-10.
Tight between these two, and fairly quick points. Luke Guang Zu, who goes into the interval with a 2-point lead here, 11-9 in game one. Good run at the moment for Luke Guang Zu. Really nicely done. He's on a roll, 5 points in a row now. He was training a short while ago, but he's put on a fantastic run here. Either way, fantastic entertainment for the crowd. We're enjoying this.
Service over. 10-13. Back
going to that Shi Yu Qi stop that run of points. It's just one on his own, and
service over.
Going to 14, a 4-point lead here.
10.
quite get it over. Shi Yu Qi maintains his 4-point lead. Lu Guang Zu.
15-11.
How much yesterday's match took out of him, Shi Yu Qi?
Yeah, that was a pretty long match, wasn't it? Against Kodai Naraoka. And he did look tired by the end of it.
And then we're still on that comeback third. Probably not quite 100% yet, are you?
Yeah, his body would definitely be feeling the after effects. That was, I think, one of the last few matches yesterday evening. So not a... less than 24 hours, he's having to back that up. No easy feat, especially against someone like Lu Guang Zu.
Thank you.
Opportunity to stretch that lead to six.
Service over 12-16.
That's more like it. From Shi. 13-16. Yeah, he kind of knew where that was going to end up. He's been very good with those jump smashers. Lu Guang Zu. Seeming to lack a little bit of consistency right now. He's getting a point here, a point there.
Yeah, I think he's not fully focused for each point, as shown by the errors coming off his racket.
That was a delightful shot, though.
And he gets those lifts, it's just so impressive at putting it away.
15-18.
Coming in. Lu Guang Zu now just two away from taking this first game.
15.
Out of the reach of Lu.
16.
Not getting much 19. Reaction out of the two men, are we?
No.
Very quiet on the court.
As we mentioned earlier in the Korea versus Korea match, it can be a bit of a different dynamic when you are playing against your compatriot.
Use your knees. Wipe the court.
Getting it all wiped out. Court maintenance.
Thank you.
Still in a decent position here, Lu Guangzu.
16-19.
Oh, that's worth a call, I think. Perhaps.
Challenges.
What do you think? Quite tight, that one.
Yeah, I thought it was in. Was it called in? What was it called?
Yeah, it was called in.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it was. There was a bit of confusion there.
Kept looking around, didn't he?
Well, I was right in the corner, so I don't think he knew which line judge he was questioning.
Oh! Oh, oh word.
Correction.
That 17, one.
19.
Good call.
Play.
From Shi Yu Qi. Just played that well. Can we put this away? No. Not yet. Excellently done by Shi Yu Qi.
He did well to get out of trouble earlier on in the rally.
18.
Beautiful slice 19. To finish it off.
Well, well. He looked like he was down and out a little earlier.
Play.
He's bounced back really well. Just the one point in it. The net, didn't it?
Oh, that went over.
Yeah, it was hard to tell, wasn't
yeah.
it? We both paused, didn't we? Thought about that, but that is sublime. And he has drawn level here. Excellent work from Shi Yu Qi. He's just suddenly come alive, isn't he, in the last couple of minutes?
Yeah, he's up the pace in these last few rallies. I think Lu is still trying to adapt to that new 19. Intensity in the rally.
And he's now got a game point here. He's won five in a row. Remember, Lu Guangzu was in an excellent position at 19-15. Shi Yu Qi looked, for all intents and purposes, out of this one. Especially with Lu Guangzu at 19-15 up. But he bounced back superbly.
I know, Lu must be very frustrated losing that lead.
Shi Yu Qi takes game one, 21-19. Thank you. So Lu Guang Zu is going to be, of course, focusing on this next game, but granted, there's no doubt at the back of his mind that precious four-point lead he had right at the end of the first game, and he couldn't finish it off.
Yeah, he definitely would have started to get a little bit excited thinking about winning that first game, just to have Shi Yu Qi up the intensity and snatch it from him.
What a time to do it. And he played some really good badminton, didn't he?
Yeah, that net cord that even we were unsure that it went over. It was so tight. Just shows someone of Shi Yu Qi's level that he can, you know, just call upon some of these high-level points when he needs them at these crucial times.
Yeah, it was a very placid, quiet affair, much of that first game. And then the intensity just built up towards the end. From the crowd, they're enjoying this. Shi Yu Qi wins a point in the end.
Definitely seems to be showing signs of his fatigue, maybe from that match yesterday, just slapping his legs a little bit after that point.
If you're Lu Guang Zu, you're obviously going to try and take advantage of that, aren't you?
Yeah, I mean, he should be trying to make the rallies a bit higher paced if he's feeling fresher. Make it physically more demanding for Shi Yu Qi.
Service over. 3-1.
Well, because of a very good year that he's had, Lu Guang Zu makes the World Tour Finals. Squeezing in, as we said, ahead of Li Zijia. So he knows he has that to look forward to. He'd really like to go out with a title to his name. The first one since 2018, which was the Australian Open. Tight, and I think rightfully so. Lu Guang Zu is going to challenge that.
Challenges called out.
He might be giving it a shout here. Oh, it is out.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 4-3 play.
It's an interesting body language from Shi Yu Qi. He's not the most energetic.
Yeah, he He looks a little lethargic today, I think.
He's been very good at that today, Lu Guangzu. Way at the moment, Shi Yu Qi. I suppose it's kind of a languid style about him. Very nicely done by Lu Guangzu.
Service over 5-7.
A little frustrating for Lu playing some of these great points and then giving these easy errors away. He knows if he keeps Shi Yu Qi within those few points that he can just have that comeback like he did in the first set. So really needs to try and make a run with these scoring points that
service over
he can make like
8-5.
So a 3-point lead here. That's good. Again, almost identical.
CUT challenges.
CUT is challenging that one.
In. Unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 9-5 play.
I think this is about as big a lead as he's had so far in
10,
quite some time.
5.
Remember that the last time he had a fairly decent lead, he lost it. He goes into the interval, Lu Guangzu in a very good position. 11-5 up in game two. He already lost that first game. Lu Guangzu is in a good position here in game two. Full of energy at the moment. Finding his marks.
Oh. service over. 6-11.
Well, that's about as energized as we've seen him in a while. Shi Yu Qi.
Blue's definitely looking the more fresh of the two right now. But still, anything a bit loose or the opportunity comes for Shi Yu Qi, he's definitely making the most of it. Blue just seems to get these leads and then let Yu Qi back in with these errors.
Yeah, I'm sure. It's going to be haunting him a little bit. Still going. Finally puts it away. Shi Yu Qi. But fantastic badminton all round. He kept it alive, didn't he, Lu Guang Zu?
9-12.
Right on the table for the crowd, and now just 3 points in it. Well, this is an excellent run from Shi Yu Qi. Suddenly come out of nowhere.
Well,
yeah, I think as soon as he's getting those shorter lifts, he feels like he has to give it everything, so he's getting opportunities right now, so he's just running with it. Lu needs to try and really bring back intensity and get the attack himself.
4 points on the trot for Shi Yu Qi. It felt like Shi Yu Qi was actually dominating that and controlling it for much of that rally. Lu Guang Zu's won it.
13-10.
That just relieved a bit of the pressure that was building on Lu Guang Zu.
Two shots to the body from Lu, causing errors from Shi Yu Qi there.
Shake of the head from Qi, who done so well to bring it back to two. Is now quickly trailing by 5. So 5-point lead here. Can he extend that? Put himself in a good position to take the second, Lu Guang Zu. quickly done by Shi Yu Qi.
Service over. 11, 15.
Definitely one of his signature shots, his cross-court slice.
So, 4 points separate these two. This was around the
11,
this was about the same sort
15.
Of deficit that Shi Yu Qi clawed back earlier in game one. He won't be too phased by that right now. He's playing that in his mind.
12-15.
He needs to try and be really disciplined here, Lou. No easy points.
Play.
I think keeping the rallies long with this lead will definitely get in Shi Yu Qi's head a little bit more.
It's just swung back and forth, isn't it? Very, very quickly.
13-15.
Now, it's around this point, around this stage earlier on that Lu Guang Zu started to pull away again. Can he do it again?
Good composure by Shi Yu Qi, not to go for any crazy shot with that last one, just realizing that he just need to play it in. That's all he had to do, and he'd be all right.
Well, he's done really well. He was trailing by five, remember? He was.
Thank you.
10, 15 down.
It's when Lu gives 14, him these opportunities and the 15. Scoreline gets closer, then. You know, if Shi Yu Qi is a bit tired and his motivation to have these long rallies is a bit up and down, then now he can see the end in sight if he can focus on these last few points. If he can wrap it up in two, that's going to encourage him.
Well, this has been absolutely remarkable from Shi Yu Qi. Again, looked in trouble, but he has bounced back superbly.
15-4.
He's just so dangerous as soon as he gets a lift that he can get behind. It's so hard to read where he's going to smash, or slice for that matter.
Desperately needed to stop this run of points, the momentum that Shi Yu Qi was building up. Lu Guang Zu has done that well. But it's anybody's game now. Of course, if Shi Yu Qi wins this, that's the match.
Thank you. 60-50.
He wants to play that again.
Lu clearly a bit frustrated with these errors.
16-4.
Chief.
17-60.
two wild smashes in a row. Seems to be getting a little desperate to wrap these points up quickly.
Thank you.
Taking this time to reset. Tie shoelaces.
The old 60. Shoelace gambit. Who's playing shots like that, very
19,
tough.
16.
Now, this is familiar territory from the last game. For Lu Guang Zu. Similar sort of lead that he had, which was whittled down by Shi Yu Qi. Annoyed.
17-19.
This time makes no mistake, and that has set up three game points for Lu Guang Zu.
20 game points, 17.
Anticipating that one. One saved.
Really nice hold up there from Shi Yu Qi at the net.
Just
getting it over Lu Guang Zu's racket right in the corner.
Higher there, Shi Yu Qi, but Lu Guang Zu has
second
taken the second game.
It's
been another long one between these two.
18,
and we're going to head into a third. So Lu Guang Zu takes game two, 21-18.
Final game, love all, play.
One game all now, and into the deciding game.
Thank you.
So for Shi Yu Qi, who's, we'll say, probably looks a little bit tired, is labored at times, especially after what's just transpired yesterday evening. He's gone all the way. He's pushed Lu Guang Zu in that second game. Good start here. What can we expect?
I think for him, he just needs to be focusing on trying to keep his intensity up in every single rally, which is easier said than done when your body just wants to, you know, be in bed, has other ideas, and you're willing it to play a three-set, you know, potentially hour-plus badminton game. Mm. So, yeah, three, a matter of pushing himself and his mind and his body to stay on top of it.
Well, this is certainly the best start he's had to any of the three games so far.
And for Shi Yu Qi, this will be his last tournament for the year. Mm. He's in the final. Hopefully he's realizing he just needs to give it everything here. And then he can, you know, take a break maybe, if the Chinese team let the players do that.
Excellent from him. Now, four unanswered points. The start of game four, or game three, excuse me, for Lava. He's just turned it on again, hasn't he?
Yeah, moving, a bit passive. Shi Yu Qi is winning so many of his points from that, the overhead smashes, so he just needs to take control of the net, I think, and not let Shi Yu Qi get the attack so easily.
Did that just tumble over?
It didn't.
Oh.
Very close, though. Oh wait, it did.
It did.
Ah.
It's all going his way at the moment. Not that time though. Finally gets his first point on the board in this third game, Lu Guang Zu. Where was this earlier? Shi Yu Qi looks reborn.
Seven, one.
At the moment, there's no answers.
Yeah, he really needs to one. Try and stop this momentum that's swinging in Shi Yu Qi's favor right now.
It's all one-way traffic at the moment. Shi Yu Qi, complete control of this third game.
Nine, one.
He's got a massive 8-point lead already. It's just like he's flicked a switch. Shi Yu Qi.
Yeah. Hopefully he can maintain it for the whole game. Has been a bit up and down his intensity throughout this match.
I may have lost the point, but there were two shots there which he wouldn't have been probably getting earlier on in the match.
Yeah, that's true.
There's one. Here's the other. Yeah.
Definitely stretched himself to get that.
Thank you. Service over. 2-9.
So this is the first time between these two that they've actually gone to a third game. All other matches have been straight game victories for either one of these players.
Service over.
10-2. Getting a little sloppy there. Grip of the racket getting a little loose.
Now he looks a bit tired, doesn't he? He put everything into that. Running at 26 shots.
Thank you.
Still very much
service over.
In control of this third game. Onto that 6-point run.
10.
Caps off a fine first half to this third game. Shi Yu Qi leading 11-3 at the break. So, Grani, an experienced player like yourself, you know, you when you're really in the zone and you're playing well, the last thing you want is any kind of break in momentum, like an interval or an injury delay or maintenance on the court. You just want to keep playing. You want to get to the next point as fast as possible, don't you?
Yeah, a break like that can definitely, stop the momentum or the run and rhythm that you're on. So it can always be a little bit of a different start after an interval. And he just needs to know that he has this scoreline because he's won all these points like that. And then he just keep up playing the same way to get the win here.
How about this drop shot?
Yeah, beautiful control, taking the pace out there.
Yeah, Lu Guang Zu, those were the sort of shots that were going in earlier.
14.
Yeah,
three.
He seems a little flustered now.
Had a quick look up there. Well, that will look and feel a little bit better. I'm not sure it will change too much in the situation. He's 10 points 30. Behind, but.
Correction, 40.
That's magnificent from Shi Yu Qi.
Lift too short 50, there off Blue's racket.
Four.
Definitely very defensive in this third game.
Good recovery, but he's just getting 60, down to those four, tougher spots much better than he was earlier. Shi Yu Qi, and now surely this is his to lose. Absolutely superb from Luke from Shi Yu Qi. He's playing some amazing shots here.
Yeah, he seems to be playing a lot more freely, using a little bit of his trick shots around the net.
He's enjoying himself. This is why he was where he was a few years ago. In the top of the tree. And he's just turned it on in this third game. So he's
18,
three away here
four,
from wrapping this up, Shi Yu Qi. Guang Zu has been blown away really in this third game. Nothing's really going his way.
19-4.
Shuttle. Really sitting on top and thinking about which way it wanted to go for a second there.
The odd point you're there for Shi Yu Qi. This is for Lu Guang Zu. This is perhaps
19.
A bit payback from the time they played at the China Open, where Lu Guang Zu and Shi Yu Qi 21-5, 21-9.
Service over.
And now 20, a whopping 15 championship points for Shi Yu Qi. Shi Yu Qi. It is a lovely way. His sixth BWF World Tour title, his second of the year after the recent Denmark Open. It has been a great couple of months for him, hasn't it?
Yeah, impressive comeback.
Throws his racket into the crowd. He's a character, Shi Yu Qi. He kind of just, when he felt like it, he turned it on, Gronje, and he played some magnificent badminton.
Yeah, I think it was a little bit of a battle in his head today, trying to will himself to give it his all.
And body.
Yeah, and body for sure. 21-5.
And the crowd want more. Here it goes. Plenty of support for Shi Yu Qi. And he's delivered the goods. I mean, it's been a really entertaining game, swung back and forth. Lu Guang Zu as well played his part in it.
Yeah, you really couldn't tell who was going to win there for a while. Lu played some great badminton, but just couldn't keep it consistent enough in the end. Shi Yu Qi just showing why he was world number two in the past, and I'm sure it's likely to be back in those ranks in no time soon as well.
Well, Luke Guang Zu will lick his wounds and make his way towards Bangkok in a couple of weeks. Shi Yu Qi ends the year having just come back into badminton with two titles to his name, playing some great stuff. He probably wants the season to continue the way he's going.
Yeah, his body might want to break, but his fair winning point. Titles, he's doing very well.
We're talking of breaks. Thank you very much, Gronje, for joining us this afternoon. We'll head to the prize presentation shortly.
Thank you.
One more match to come. So now we'll have that prize presentation for the men's singles.
Ladies and gentlemen, your runner-up of the men's singles, Lu Guang Zu from China. And to present the runner-up medal, Ranko Medijevic. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the men's singles for 2022, Shi Yu Qi from China. CEO of the SATHIO Group, Paul SATHIO, to present the winner's medal. Let's hear it for your men's singles finalists.
So, a superb match we've just seen there, and a big smile from Shi Yu Qi. Why not, after he put on a wonderful exhibition of badminton in that third and final game, to be his compatriot. Up next, the final match of the day, the men's doubles. Ong Yusin and Chiu Yi versus Liu Yuchen and Ho Xuanyi of China. We are back with a vibrant, raucous Key Center with the crowd really getting into it here. They've been entertained with some superb badminton, particularly in that last men's singles final. We now have